Maybe we have been even preaching yaqeen, faith and conviction. And very rare to find implementing yaqeen. And I'm talking to brothers and sisters, individuals and families and communities. Whom you fear, you're going to tell me, I'm sure, anyone here will answer the same question. Who is the one you fear?
Allah.
Huh?
Allah.
Only?
One.
Are you sure?
Yes,
sure. Fine. We will get from the list of our daily activities what will say 10 no's, not yes. What we are going to keep saying yes, only Allah. Only Allah. How many times you have false witness because you are worrying about your job? How many times you kept worrying about the culture and families and tribes and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet are saying something different. What I can do, man, just like culture and just like... Huh? You know that what you are doing for to live is haram? Yes, but you know that Allah is the Razak, the sustainer? Yes. Are you ready to resign in the morning? But whom you fear? Allah. What Allah you talking about? Which Allah? What Suhaib did? I need you to answer, so you are gonna go and look at the mirror saying, X, you need to stop lying. What Suhaib did? We know Suhaib, the Roman guy, one of the companions of Muhammad, who came to Mecca with nothing, trivial, owning nothing. He accepted Islam and he's one of the top businessmen in Mecca. And the deal was what?
Leave all Islam.
Huh? Then? Or?
Or convert.
Or do something. Whatever is the deal is. To migrate. You want to migrate? You want to join Muhammad? You want to join your guy? You came here nothing, leave here with nothing. Huh? What he did?
He left.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Did he think?
No.
Did he bargain?
No.
Did he try to make a deal? What he did? Left what? Left what?
And
everything. You came with that old garment and jilbab, you are gonna leave Mecca the same way you came. Go! And even from the believer, they will tell him, Suhaib, your iman is good. Make a deal, man, with them. Let's do something to maintain, to keep. Guys, I'm okay, I'm gonna stay here, and next day you can escape. He never even brought the idea to the table. Huh? He left? Good. With nothing. How we can make that deal? We have the two battles. One is saying, see man, you did something good, but the other side is saying, see, you lost 25 years of struggling you lost it in a day. How many of us are running through the same? Maybe daily, maybe monthly, maybe annually, whatever the frequency is. Oh, I didn't know that what I have been doing for the last 20 years is haram. And you are telling me right now that I have been a musician and I have been just like a singer. And you are telling me all what I have collected and in order to please Allah, I have to get rid of everything and just... I'm gonna start a new page, but with my stuff. Fine. Then, who is the sustainer? No, just like, I fear Allah, but the other side, you will be poor. You will get back to nothing. You will get back even not to find a piece of bread to eat. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did say in the Quran, الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمْ الْفَقْرِ. Shaitan will come and keep threatening you for being poor and losing everything in this dunya. And Allah in the same verse, وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising مغفرة, forgiveness, huh? What else? وَفَضْلًا, a favor. never lose even this dunya. Because what you look from outside, you lost. But what you feel from inside, no one can feel the sweetness but you. Somebody's gonna look at others, how bad they are looking. And they are inside the happiest people in the world. And that's the reason I started with what Ibn Taymiyyah says. He said, if the kings know what, how sweet are the iman that we feel inside our hearts, huh? They would have fought against us with swords to take it out of our hearts. Because that cannot be bought with money. Regardless how much you have. How many you know that you want to sacrifice all of their wealth to get a child, to be recovered from their cancer, to feel a minute of happiness, real happiness in their life. Many, many, many. Because the equation is different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making it different. What we are talking about is those of yaqeen. So here, no one can be away from that other side. We need to understand that. Even the companions of Muhammad, everyone will have the two sides. Because that is the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did create any human being. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. That is the way that the nafs has been created. Ha. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا. Any nafs has been created with the two sides. And any nafs, the two will be playing the game against one another. Any nafs. Any, even the prophets, the whole thing, who's gonna win, how big, how strong is one of them. One of them could be a million points, and the other could be half, so it's considered almost negligible. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. The winner is the one who will bring the, will have this. The winner is the real iman, who will purify his soul to have the yaqeen. So let me check with the Prophet. He never even did. Or let me see what, no, that's what you need. It's already established in his heart. Anything. Any, and I'm saying any. So we can start removing a little bit of that crazy or the new way of thinking about Islam. We kept using compromising till we have started to compromise in La ilaha illallah. Isn't it?
What's wrong?
Just, who said that Christians are going to the hellfire? We should not tell them that. Just we'll tell them everything's okay, you are okay. And somebody should, we need to understand. I'm asking you a question. If a person will die saying Allah is the third of a three, he is going to make it to hellfire or not, regardless who it is. I didn't say Obama. I didn't say Bush. I didn't say a name. I didn't mention a friend of mine. I didn't say it. I said, whomever will pass away, and he has the faith that Allah is the third of a three, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Uzayr, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Isa ibn Maryam. Is he gonna make it to the hellfire?
Yes.
Is he considered kafir?
Yes.
Simple. I'm saying, Allah says, I didn't say, oh my friend Mina, oh my friend George, you are kafir. I didn't say that. George and Mina might accept Islam before death. Oh yeah, why you are strong with them? Why you are aggressive? I'm not aggressive. I'm saying what Allah did reveal in the Quran. And I'm gonna reply their question with a question. You George, what do you say about me saying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah in your book? You know what they will say? Huh? Hellfire. Simple. They will say you are in the hellfire. Then what's wrong? They are saying about whomever is saying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, whomever is not believing in the Trinity or what? Jesus is the Son of God. And then why you to be just a cool? What coolness you are talking about? To the extent that we lost our deen. Oh, what just a, why a man, a Muslim man, Allah, he can get married to a non-Muslim or one of the people of the scripture, woman, and why it's not the other way? Can a Muslim woman get married? Yeah, it can, but can? What can? What can? Because I don't want to tell, I don't want to be just like a, say I don't know, we can accept it. But to start just like, I want to start with him so I can give him da'wah. Which da'wah? I'm telling you, one day he will give you da'wah and you will, I'll pick you one day from the church. What? We have started to compromise. I'm going to try to finish. I'm trying to just like, to own in my back home, then only the swimming pool, then I'm going to stop the haram. You know it's haram? Yes, I know it's haram. Then, and the disaster that the one who is compromising will stand up saying, Ya Akhi, Allah is the most merciful. Why you are making it, I did make it tough? You need to reply to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Are you understanding the mercy of Allah more the one whom Allah did call him the mercy to all alameen? Which mercy are you talking about? My heart is wide, don't worry, everything is okay. Are you praying? No, but everything will be okay. Okay, you are talking about compromise. Just like losing Fajr for a few days, not a big deal, but I am on. Which on? You are off. Which on you are talking about? What Suhaib did? It's one deal. What Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam did meet him at the first meeting in Medina? Huh?
What a profitable
thing. Everyone is thinking, oh, how bad the money that Suhaib lost. The first statement from the tongue of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the first meeting, how great prophet you have achieved, my companion Suhaib. رَبِحَ الْبَيْعُ يَا صُهَيْبُ. You have signed an absolutely profitable deal. With whom? Simple. Whomever is given sadaqah to Allah, Allah is giving him what? Huh? Whomever is doing a righteous deed, huh? In Islam, it's multiplied by minimum. Is it correct? Sure.
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Can you go and donate 1,000 dirhams right now? Ten? You are the one who told me the hadith. Is Allah multiplying by 10? Yes, but. Is it correct? Which but? And you can give me more than one hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is multiplying for others even in hundreds. Is it correct? And not only that, you tell me, don't worry. I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Not only, it's not only 10, it's not only hundreds, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply even more to whoever He wish. Huh? Go ahead. Give. That's the problem. The companion has told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, what is the distance between me and Jannah? He said, this better. But, and then, just go there, be killed, pass away to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as martyr, you are in Jannah.